Good morning, students. Today we are going to study about shape, size and number of the cell. Then we study a structure of the cell. At first, we going through shape of the cell. Shape of the cell vary according to their function. As per the function, their shape is round, oval, spindle, irregular, branched, etc. Then, size of the cell is also depend on their function. Some cells have transmission function, they are longest. Some have covering, they are flat. Some are oval. As is, there are different shapes, size of cell also. Number of cell vary in organelles. Some organelles made up of only one cell, they are called single celled animal. As for example, amoeba, euglena, paramecium, etc. Whereas some organisms made up of more than two cells, they are called multicellular organisms. Multicellular organisms, example plant, animal and human beings also. Then their all life activities perform in different cell, whereas in unicellular all life activity perform in single cell. Then we study a structure of cell. We know there are three part of cell: plasma membrane, means cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. Cell membrane is flexible, elastic, selective, semi permeable membrane which bounded the cell. It is made up of bilayer of lipids and proteins. It is called selective membrane because it select the materials as per requirement of the cell to come inside or outside. Then the cell allowed the materials across through them. They are of three types: membrane called impermeable, when nothing allowed to pass through them; permeable, when both allowed to pass through them, means solvent or solute both; and semi-permeable, when only solvent allowed to pass through them. Cell membrane is special. It is semi-permeable selective membrane, means it allowed solvent but only when cell required. As per requirement, they select the materials. Then it pass the materials by two method: passive transport method and active transport method. Passive transport method, when energy required. Passive transport method, when energy is not required, it is by two method: diffusion or osmosis. That means it is natural, there is no requirement of energy. Diffusion, you know, movement of molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. Whereas osmosis is a special diffusion of water, movement of water molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration through semi-permeable membrane. That is called osmosis. Osmosis is always occurs in living because two condition is a special. First one is only water molecules move, and second one is cell membrane required through cell membrane. Then osmosis categorized in two type: endoosmosis and exoosmosis. Endoosmosis, when water comes inside the cell, and exoosmosis, when water moves outside the cell. Then the solution as per the concentration of water is of three types: hypotonic, isotonic and hypertonic solution. Hypotonic solution is dilute, that have more water compared to the cell contents. When cell kept in hypotonic solution, endoosmosis occurs and the cell will swell. Example, when we kept gram seeds in water, then you find it swells up. That is endosmosis. Then isotonic solution, second type. Isotonic solution, concentration of water is same to the equal to the cell content. So there is no osmosis. Third one is hypertonic solution. It has less water content to the cell. So when cell kept in hypertonic solution, exosmosis occurs. In plant cells, the shrinking protoplasm will contract from the cell wall. That means cytoplasm separated to the cell wall is called plasmolysis. That is due to exosmosis. During this exosmosis, the cell will shrink. Then active transport method is required energy. Usually occurs engage the concentration gradients. Then third one is special bulk transport. That means transport of material in large amount across the plasma membrane as endocytosis or phagocytosis, means outside to inside, is found in ingestion of food in amoeba, and exocytosis found in amoeba when they excrete the materials. Here in this notes, you find three type: hypotonic, isotonic, and hypertonic solution. Then, cell wall is another structure made up of cellulose that found in plant cells outside the cell membrane. This gives rigidity to the cell, plant cell. That cell shape is different in plant. It also provides protection. Then second part is cytoplasm that consists two part, matrix cell organelles, and matrix is liquid part made of water, organic, inorganic material that provides site for proper functioning of the cell organelle. Well, cell organelle, in next video we study one by one.